our family and friends for spending our special day with us. We know some of you have come from really far places, places such as east of the 605 freeway, San Diego, San Francisco, Texas, Chicago, Florida, New York, and even from Taiwan. Manhattan Beach as well. We wanted to thank our bridesmaid and groomsmen for all the help they provided us. We wanted to thank Pam and Tiffany for their help, Stephen for your wonderful cookies, Jason, Jimmy, and Mikey for their help on the photo booth. And of course, I didn't want to forget little Aaron, little Maddox, and Princess Ava. I think I hear the Oscar music playing, so I'm going to stop right here. But here's a toast to a happy marriage, good health for all, and a wonderful night.
I do my best to find some kind of glow. I'm giving it some heart and soul now. From the darkest grays, the sun bursts, clouds break. Yeah, we see that fire.
And it has truly my pleasure to introduce our bride and groom tonight, Mr. and Mrs. John and Julie J.
With someone who loves you just as you are. Yes, with imperfections, but with great, great potential. With all that you have been and all that you are becoming. You know, there's an old Chinese proverb that states, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step.
Driving at BMW when we first met, and then later switching to a Toyota Prius quickly after we started dating. Part of the reason I was able to do this is because through our time together, you helped me realize what is truly important in life. It is not the material things that one owns, but it is the time that we have to spend with each other.
Julie and John, I believe love can last forever and grow even stronger with time. And that's what I'm wishing for you, too. Here's to love.
Here's to a lifetime of happiness, Julie and John. Love you, John. Love you, Julie.
John, you take Julie to be your wedded wife. You promise to love her, honor, care, with tenderness and affection throughout all the circumstances of your lives together.
I do.
I've learned so much about you, but yet, I do not know everything about you. when I first met you, I thought you were a baller, driving that BMW. I thought you liked to clean. Your house was so neat and organized. I thought you liked to hike, as that was our first adventure. As I cooked for you, you said you can cook too, or even better. Little did I know, the BMW became a Prius. Your place is a mess thanks to me. You only like to hike because of me. And you said you can cook. You almost burned down our kitchen. I guess I'll do the cooking from now. I know that I will always learn something from you or about you, even when we're together for 100 years. And I look forward to that 100 years together. John, I know you're not perfect, and I know I'm not perfect, but together we are perfect. You're tall, I'm kind of tall. You're super on time, and I try to be on time. You like to balance your money, and I like that you will be balancing our money. I can't wait for my little black hole account where I don't know where the money's gonna go. As I stand here in front of our family and friends, I make my promises to you. I promise to be more organized and less messy. But they do say, organized people are those who are too lazy to look for things. I promise to hand over the remote when there is a USC game. I'll even try to watch the game with you without falling asleep. At least we'll be spending quality time together, right? I promise to support you in all your endeavors, even if that means to my roots. I promise to respect you, communicate to you, and love you with all my heart. John, my partner, I can't wait to start our family together and spend the rest of my life with you. I love you.
And by the power vested in me by the state of California, and in the name of God, I now pronounce that you are husband and wife. You may start your happily ever after with a kiss.